Okay. Hello, 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 everybody, to another FM Signals Info Show Video Edition. My name is Still Damian Galt from good old Germany, and welcome to today's politics news update. It's Friday, meanwhile, the 17th August 2012. It's 5:38 in the morning, Central European Time, and yeah, the topic of this politics news updates is or are the political elections in 2012, end of the year. I want to get concentrating the next important ones. These are, in my opinion, Hong Kong for us, from the view of us of forex traders, of course, in Hong Kong, the Netherlands, and the United States. So I want to give you a shortly overview about the yield curve of the Hong Kong dollar, euro, US dollar, and the 10-year bond yields, and of the cross rate. So analyze the stuff again, like always. Put these infos in the back on your mind. Not concrete forex trading capabilities. Much more for the back of your mind. Okay, guys, here we are. Here we go with the worldwide elections until the end of 2012. Here's the calendar of electionguide.com. Here I'm copying and pasting in. So, yes, yeah, that's not my picture or my calendar. However, electionguide.com. So, you can get much more infos about worldwide elections until end of 2012. So here the calendar. I don't want to go into detail. Every Angola, Hong Kong, Netherlands, Belarus, Georgia, Venezuela, Montenegro, Ukraine, and so long, so long. So worldwide calendar. So, and I want to much more focusing or concentrating on the next one, and in our context, even of from a perspective or a view of forex traders, which my viewers are, is Hong Kong, Netherlands, and the United States important? By the way, on the 11th September or 9/11 in Germany, we will also have a decision about the euro. So, and yes, from the justice side, so it will be an interesting and warm back to school season start. So here 9/11 Hong Kong decision, then also in Germany, then 12/11 we'll have a decision in 9/12 in Netherlands, and in November, of course, the presidential in the excuse me, in the United States. So yes, take care about this datas. It will be surely windy. I don't know, from the left or the right side, it will be from above or down under, so will give us resistance or push up, even in every asset you're trading, so forex, commodities, or even equities. However, I want to showing you the yield curves, but I don't, I can't upload it. I don't find the picture. Excuse me. So I've got here the table of last week here in Hong Kong, and what I want to show you is that we've got here in the Hong Kong also here in the not unusual yield curve, so a longer bond, higher yield price usually, of course, don't need to explain why. Longer, it's even like if you borrow someone money and you also wanna have more, you higher price payback as long as you borrow him the money. So usually longer, how to say in English, yes, longer borrowing time, higher yield price. And interesting is, in the Hong Kong yield curve, we see here at 3 year and 4 year inverted, how to say in English, yes, inverted. So, and don't ask me how, That's also a signal, but yes, don't ask me why. The same stuff we see here in the Netherlands, a usually yield curve, but here on the in the 1 year, 3 month, 6 month, 1 year, we see here zero or underwater yields. Of course, reflects even the yes the problems or the divergence in Europe between the GIBS and the middle states and northern states in Europe. So, and we will see what will happen even in the parliamentary elections in the Netherlands, yes, parliamentary on the 12th September. So here in US we've got a usually yield curve. Oh, excuse me, in the morning. So I've got a frog in my mind. Okay, here we've got a usually yield curve, higher prices, longer yield, higher yield price. So all in all, pretty normal. So however, let's get concentrating about the 10 years and even the cross rates. So I'm painting here the 10-year yield of the Hong Kong dollar. We see a fall since April 2000. Well, this year, last month. So here, and here I'm overlaid here the Euro Hong Kong dollar chart. We see here pretty high correlation. So from the European view, it's attractive, still attractive, but not so much as it was here to sell Euro Hong Kong dollar or even buy treasuries, Hong Kong treasuries from the Europe perspective. Even how to say carry trade, like, or yeah, if you want to play this stuff. However, the next the same stuff here we can make with the Hong Kong dollar 10 yield and the US dollar. So about the US dollar and Hong Kong dollar is even like in a how to say pact. So it's not it's even like in a pact. So not free floated like the another cross rates. So, and we see here also another tight correlation, even like in the Euro Hong Kong dollar, based on the 10 year yields in Hong Kong. So what's much more interesting are this one. Look at this, guys, the 10-year yield of the Netherlands, we see here. So, and the Euro Hong Kong dollar, and here we see also a pretty tight correlation. So here, so and here the same stuff with the 10 yield about the Euro dollar, 10-year Netherlands Euro dollar, also pretty tight. So more or less, of course, here some divergence also, but the same trend. All in all, to come to a point, US dollar 10 year yield, here we see non-correlation with the US dollar, Hong Kong dollar, and here 10-year yield with the Euro dollar, pretty correlation here. Not exact like the Euro Hong Kong dollar, but we can say it's a correlation here. Look at this. Oh, here, see, I don't got the Euro dollar data last week. However, here the yields broke up, and here the Euro dollar is still at this plate. So however, analyze the stuff again, it's still your guys. And I wanna go away or move forward with the Hong Kong dollar. So I'm I'm showing here, I'm uploading you here in Hong Kong dollar chart. So to give you here for forex trading and trading capability is the Hong Kong dollar. So don't put these facts in the back of your mind. Euro dollar, Hong Kong dollar yields correlated with the 10-year yields. Euro Hong Kong dollar on both sides, the Netherlands and the Hong Kong dollar, and Euro dollar also correlated in the last time with the 10-year yield in America. So, and the second strategic forks are even the elections in the back to the school season, starting at 10th in 3 weeks, 10th September. Yes, even in 3 weeks. And until that, I want to give you here an outlook about the Hong Kong dollar index. The Hong Kong dollar index is an index which I created by my own, or I'm starting to create, I'm testing it. But here I've got a few data here, Hong Kong dollar versus Hong Kong dollar against the Argentine peso, Australian dollar, Brazilian real, Canada dollar, all big currencies, even to Taiwan dollar, US dollar, South African ZAR, even like the cross rates at our real-time live charts homepage. So 24 currencies, index components, 24, wave 4.17 everyone. And so I simply add all cross rates, starting with the Hong Kong dollar. So lower index, lower Hong Kong dollar, higher index, higher Hong Kong prices. And here we see here and 2010 and 11, in the mid of 2011, we've got here lower prices in the Hong Kong dollar here. And then we've got here higher Hong Kong dollar prices against the other currencies. So, and I want to give you here a startup setup. Yes. Oh, excuse me. Setup here for the autumn or until the elections. Here, look at this, guys, from technical view. Here, the low 2011, the low 2012. Here we see the high 2011 and the high at start 2012. So that's the basic asymmetric triangle. So very interesting stuff. And if we are creating here extended right, we see here we've got here a great upside trend in Hong Kong dollar. And that's then week before this break up, I said before, I've got problems here with the data, also with the yields. Yes, here with my MetaStock software. And however, this is the chart until last Friday before 3rd August 2012. Meanwhile, we are trading here a little bit higher, so we are not in a falling knife. But however, it's not for day trading usefully. It's much more for the back of your mind and a great setup if you're trading the Hong Kong dollar. So excuse me here why I don't got here real time or yes, much more data. However, so back to the future here, and here the basic setup here, the upside trend here, the downside trend of the highs 2011 2012, and we see here we are here at very high levels right here, right now. So, or was, we were here in the second quarter 2012, so in the Hong Kong dollar. So, and here are the date when the elections will be, 9th September 9/9/12. So, and until that, I'm thinking here we will be in consolidate here in the Hong Kong dollar, and then we will see what will happen. Even perhaps we will get support, reason to buy or to sell Hong Kong dollar. We will see what will happen. So that's the setup, the strategic forks if you're trading the Hong Kong dollar. To come to a point or to an end, perhaps here much more, let's go a little bit much more into detail. Here this one and this one, the highs, and if we make here this extend right line, here we see Yeah, we've got here these high levels, and we fall here perfectly down for 2 weeks, and now we are here consolidating and perhaps unspoken waiting here for a decision, and then we will see what will happen, in which way the Hong Kong dollar will move. And this is also, in my opinion, also a great example even for the other assets here until the markets. If you're trading Forex, I mean it's now the big currencies, euro or dollar, here we will also have here in November presidential elections. Here we will have also 1 day later or 2 days later Germany decision about the euro, 1 day later in Netherlands. So it will be a warm political back to school season start, and the markets are waiting. Which asset class you're trading, I'm feeling it. Perhaps it's an illusion from my side, but I'm thinking the markets are accepting and waiting for a decision, and then hopefully we can go back to the basics, back to the economic facts, data, figures, and annual reports of the equities. So until that, we will see from the political side where the wind will come from. So from the left, right, above, or hopefully from the bottom up, so that we can rise in which asset class we want. However, that's all for today. And lots of stuff again. I'm hopefully here a great setup if you're trading the Hong Kong dollar. And thanks for watching my video and spending your time. And perhaps once again, the political news update from today, political election 2012, concentrating back to school season, Hong Kong, Netherlands, United States, and German decision about the euro. And I'm hoping you've got some new point of views about the setup in the Hong Kong dollar. So let's prepare for the back to school season. It's a little bit not high volatile in which asset class you want, Forex, commodities, or even equities. And yes, lately in the second September week, we are all back to business. So until that, make the best of now. And yes, good morning, good day, and good night, wherever and whenever you're watching my FM Signals Info Show videos. My name is Hilda Megaj from good old Germany. It's meanwhile 6 o'clock, 6 in the morning, Central European Time, on Friday, the 17th August 2012. Thank you for spending your time and have a great weekend. Of course, I will uploading a technical analysis news update while Wall Street session today. Oh shit, das war echt ein scheiß Video heute.
Das war echt scheiße. Das hat mir nicht gefallen.
Shade of my emotion, add the color to my scripture feet.